Hello everyone, welcome back with the new world of food drugs. So here we are going to start with new subject, that is the pharmacognosy. This pharmacognosy, it is a branch of science that deals with the study of different food drugs. These food drugs are obtained from natural sources like plants, animals and mineral kingdom. So here is the first topic of our subject, that is the introduction to pharmacognosy. In introduction to pharmacognosy, we are going to study about the definition, history and scope of pharmacognosy. I am Mrs. Shagupta Zubair Pathan, working as lecturer in KCT Krishna College of Pharmacy, Karar. If you have any query or doubt, you can contact me on srb.tkcp@gmail.com. Let's start with first point, that is the introduction. Basically, pharmacognosy, it is nothing but it is the knowledge of drugs. Let's see the definition of pharmacognosy. Pharmacognosy is defined as it is a scientific and systematic study of structural, physical, chemical, and biological characters of food drugs, along with its history, method of cultivation, collection, and preparation for the market. Means what? In pharmacognosy, as it is the branch of science, we are going to study different food drugs. We are going to study different parameters of food drugs, and these parameters are common name of drug, family of drug, botanical source or biological source of drug, geographical source of drug. There are different methods of cultivation, collection and preparation for the market of these drugs, morphological and microscopic studies, phytoconstituents, that is the chemical constituents which are responsible to cause pharmacological action of the drug, then its pharmacological effects or therapeutic effects. If there are certain adulterants, we are going to study about the adulterants and allied drugs. So all these parameters are studied in pharmacognosy branch. You have to remember the definition, as it is very important for your examination. It is nothing but it is scientific, systematic study of structural, physical, chemical and biological characters of food drugs, along with their history, method of cultivation, collection and preparation for the market. See the next point. Basically, this pharmacognosy, it is a combination of words. In that, pharmakon, it is a Greek word and it means a drug. Second is gignosko. Gignosko, it is also a Greek word and it means to acquire knowledge of. Or cognosko means to know about. It is a Latin word. So basically, pharmacognosy means to acquire knowledge of drug. Pharmakon, it is a Greek word. Gignosko, it is also a Greek word. And both these words, that they gives idea about what it deals with, what this branch deals with. So pharmacognosy, it is nothing but it is to acquire knowledge of drug. See the importance of pharmacognosy. The study of this pharmacognosy branch, we can study different crude drugs which are derived from different natural sources. Also, it is an important branch of science that is very, very useful in pharmaceutical research and development. It gives us a tool for identification of different crude drugs. It is very it is a good platform for the physicochemical characterization of these drugs. We can cultivate different drugs according to its therapeutic use. We can extract their phytoconstituents. It is very, very useful in biological assessment. It is also very important in quality control aspect, and we can prepare according to the market strategies, according to the industries. See the next definition, that is the definition of crude drugs. In the study of pharmacognosy, we should know about the crude drugs. What is crude drug? It should be known to us. Crude drugs are nothing but these are the natural products. that are obtained from natural sources like plants, animals, minerals or other, which after collection they are subjected only to drying or making them into transverse or longitudinal slices or peeling them in some cases. Examples: acacia, ginger, cinchona, benzoin, datura, etc. In crude drugs, these are the natural products, means what? We can get these crude drugs naturally. So definitely they are not synthetic products or they are not a semi-synthetic products. So from where we can get these crude drugs? We can get these crude drugs from plant origin, animal origin, mineral origin or other natural sources. These crude drugs are undergoes only the process of drying and only the process of slicing. That means we are going to slice them into transverse or longitudinal sections. So this is about the crude drug. I am repeating here the definition of crude drug. Crude drugs are natural products that are obtained from natural sources like plants, animals, minerals and others, which after collection are subjected only to drying or making them into transverse or longitudinal slices or peeling them in some cases. Examples: in examples you can write example of acacia, ginger, cinchona, benzoin, datura, etc. Let's see the next part, that is the history of pharmacology. In history, the first is Egyptians. They found the basic treatment with the use of these natural drugs for different ailments. So Egyptians were aware of the medicinal uses of these all plants and animals, and they also very well known about the human anatomy of human body. And they wrote all the information in a document that is called as Ebers Papyrus in 1550s. So as mentioned in Papyrus Ebers, it is an old document that is written in 1550 BC. Egyptians, they were aware of the whole knowledge of these plants and animals and also about the human anatomy. Then the second scientist is Aristotle. Aristotle, he was a renowned philosopher in 384 to 322 BC, and he was well known for his studies on animal kingdom. Next scientist is Theophrastus. Theophrastus in 370 to 287 BC, and he was well known for his study on plant kingdom. Next scientist is Pliny the Elder, who compiled 37 volumes of natural history. Next and very very important is C.A. Sadler. While studying sarsaparilla, it was C.A. Sadler, he was a German scientist, who coined the term pharmacognosy in 1815. In his work, it is entitled as Analecta Pharmacognostica. It is, as I have told you, that it is made up of two Greek words, pharmakon means a drug and gnosko means to acquire knowledge of. So C.A. Sadler was a German scientist who coined the term pharmacognosy in 1850, and he wrote the book Analecta Pharmacognostica. Next scientist, Hippocrates. Hippocrates, he was known as father of medicine, and he deals with study of human anatomy and physiology of human being. So in 460 to 360 BC, he is known as father of medicine. He was a Greek physician, and he was the first to study anatomy and physiology of human being. He also prepared a physician's oath, which is used till today. Then the next scientist is Dioscorides. In 40 to 80 AD, he was a Greek physician, and he described several plants of medicinal importance in a book that is called as De Materia Medica. Next scientist is Sushruta. Sushruta. Indian history of medicinal plants is dated back to 3500 BC. The curative properties of all plants have been mentioned in Ayurveda. There are suktas of Ayurveda, that is Rig Veda and Atharva Veda. In Rig Veda and Atharva Veda, all the importance of plants it is mentioned. Ayurveda has also described very good number of plants with their therapeutic properties. The ancient well-known treatises in Ayurveda, Charak Sanhita and Sushruta Sanhita. Sushruta, he wrote the Sushruta Sanhita that describes the procedure of surgery, and Charak, he wrote Charak Sanhita that deals with plant. Next scientist is Galen. Galen was the Greek pharmacist in 131 to 200 AD. He described various methods of preparations containing active constituents of crude drugs, and even at present, the branch that deals with the extraction of these plants and animals, it is called as Galenical pharmacy. So Galen was a Greek pharmacist and he worked on extraction of chemical constituents from the plants. He developed various methods of extraction. Therefore, the branch of pharmacy that deals with extraction of these chemical constituents from plants and animals, it is called as Galenical pharmacy. Next point is various indigenous systems of medicine. Indigenous systems of medicine means what? The traditional systems of medicine that is followed traditionally. In that, you know about the Ayurveda, Siddha, Yunani, homeopathy, naturopathy, and yoga. These are the different indigenous systems of medicine that are followed by world. Ayurveda. Ayurveda that deals with basic use of herbs. Ayurveda, it is the oldest system of medicine in India. In Ayurveda, there is a supposition that everything in the universe, it is made up of five basic elements. That is called as Pancha Mahabhuta: solid, liquid, air, space, and energy. These five elements exist in the body. They combine in the form of Vata, Pitta and Kapha. These three forms are togetherly called as Tridosh. And there are seven forms of Tridosh that are called as Saptadhatu. These Saptadhatu undergoes wear and tear process and they form a excretory material or mala. The wear and tear process, we can call it as a metabolism. When these three dosh, that is Saptadhatu and Mala, are in the balanced form, then the condition is healthy. And if it is in imbalanced form, then there are pathological disorders. In Ayurveda, Charak Sanhita and Sushruta Sanhita are the two well-known treatises. In Charak Sanhita, it describes the importance of plants as a medicine. And in Sushruta Sanhita, a special emphasis is given on surgery. So this system of Ayurveda, it is an ancient science and it deals with life originated in India about 3000 years ago. The principle of this positive health and therapeutic measures, it is embedded in the system of Ayurveda. And this encompasses of knowledge of Kaya Chikitsa, Kaumarya Vridhya, Prav Chikitsa, Shalakya Tantra, ophthalmology means Shalakya Tantra, Agada Tantra, Shalya Tantra, Rasayana Tantra, etc. Next is Siddha system of medicine. The term Siddha means achievement, and Siddhas, these are the saintly personalities. They attain proficiency in medicine through the practice of Bhakti and Yoga. And this is the system in pre-Vedic period that is identified by Dravidian culture. Like Ayurveda, this system believes that all objects in the universe, they are also made up of five basic elements: earth, water, sky, fire and air. And the identification of positive factor with each gender of disease that is done by pulse reading, color, or body.